Now we'll start our discussion for sound waves. We know well that sound waves are longitudinal waves in which medium particles oscillate along the direction of propagation of energy. So let's first discuss about the actual motion of medium particles according to the displacement curve for a simple harmonic wave if it is representing a sound wave. You know well that in case of a simple harmonic wave, if we draw the displacement curve, it looks like this. A wave is propagating with a speed v in forward direction. Say at origin, medium particle is connected to oscillator which oscillates between plus A and minus A, which is the amplitude of wave. And say the positions are O, P, Q, R, S, T. These are the points where the particle is located at mean position during the wave propagation. And there are some particles which are at extreme position in the wave train. If this is the displacement curve for a simple harmonic wave, which is giving us the position of particles at their position, displacement of particles at their position as a function of time. If we just map it in a physical medium, say if this is the actual wave in a medium, and we can see corresponding points which are at O, P, Q, R, S, T and so on. These are the points which will be at their mean position. Wave is propagating at a speed v, and here we can say as displacement curve is giving us the displacement of particles from mean position. Here we can see that the medium particles are oscillating along the direction of propagation. So if its equation is given as y equals to a sine of omega t minus kx, then x is giving us here the position of particle and y is the displacement. So, in a longitudinal wave, displacement is given along x. So, always remember, you can also write down a note that in longitudinal waves, y is measured along the direction of x only. Like here we can say if a medium particle is located here which is at a displacement y1, this is positive displacement above the x-axis in displacement curve, then we can say this particle at this instance is located at a displacement y1 ahead of its mean position because it is positive. Similarly, if we talk about another particle which is at a displacement minus y2, y2 is negative. That means this particle is at this instant, it is located at a distance y2 behind its mean position because the particles are oscillating back and forth because it is a longitudinal wave. Now in this situation, if we just have a look on the situation, all those particles which are located between point Q and R are having some positive displacement. That means all those particles which are between Q and R are located slightly ahead of their mean position, that will be in the neighborhood of this point R. And all those particles which are between R and S are having some negative displacement. That means all these particles in the actual medium between point R and S are located behind their mean position. So these are again in the neighborhood of R. So similarly, we can see the point P. At the left of P, all particles are having a positive displacement, means all these particles are located near to P. All those which are between P and Q are having negative displacement, so these are near to P again. So we can see for P and R, the medium density will increase, but at point Q, the particles on the left of Q are displaced back particles on the right of Q are displaced toward right. So at Q, medium density will be less. Similarly, T is the point where medium density will increase and at point S it will decrease. So we can say these are the point P, R, T where the density of medium is more. These are called points of compressions. And these are the point where the medium density is less are called points of rarefaction. Similarly, this point, if we take it U, this is also the point of rarefaction. So, as in a transverse wave, actually crest and troughs propagate, in a longitudinal wave, compression and rarefaction propagates. Here, you should also keep in mind that at various positions, the density of medium is varying, so medium pressure will also vary periodically with time. So, this is how we represent longitudinal wave. And always remember, compression and rarefaction occur only corresponding to those positions where particles are at mean position. Those particles which are at extreme positions have moderate density, as on both sides the density is slightly higher and lower. So on an average we can say those particles which are at extreme position in a longitudinal wave will have normal atmospheric density, or the medium density is at a normal level.